Hello everyone and welcome to another product introduction video. My name is Oliver Draper, CTO for COP, and the product we've got to show today is the brand new Hikvision two-wire analog intercom system. So this is brand new. As I mentioned, it is an analog version. Unlike the digital one where you've got to do some IP configuration over various bits and pieces, even operating over two-wire, this one is fully analog, meaning you don't need to connect it to a network in any way. On the back of the device, we'll take a look at shortly, there is some twist dials that you twist just to address the actual door station. Now, door stations a little bit different, also as is the indoor stations. These, again, do have the twist dials on the back, which you just turn just to address these so they can talk all on the same system. Now, in addition, again, all the peripherals are totally different to what you get on the ordinary two-wire system, IP one or the digital one, as I should say. This is the CAD distribution box, the 7060. What makes this different to the other 706 distributor boxes that you get with the digital version? This one, for starters, is 48 volt DC in. The other ones is 24 volt. You also do not get a LAN port on the back of this one to connect to a network because it is a fully analog system. The idea being it doesn't need to connect to a network, you just address the twist dials on the back and away you go. It has got the six channels at the top there that allows you to connect in a door station, then five indoor stations, those screens. You've also got the in and out ports there so you can actually cascade and daisy chain onto other boxes should you wish to expand the system. Now, because it's 48 volt DC in, it does mean the power supply is a lot bigger than what you get with the traditional digital system. So this is the 48 volt power supply that is also required to power the system. Now, this one can be expanded. It can be a fairly decent size of all being analog. Obviously, we've got 48 volts to play with there. Now, when you hook in the screens, they can star wire off the distributor box. That's absolutely fine. We can daisy chain the screens because if we look at the back of one of the screens, they plug into the bottom there. You go two wire in and then you've got a two wire out, meaning you can just daisy chain the screens one after the other, as like the image I'm putting on the screen for you now. In addition to that as well, depending on the size of your topology, they also do what's called a floor shunt. This means you can just run a simple two-wire from your distributor box going off to another floor. And then when you get to the floor shunt, you can then use this to actually daisy chain or star wire off there as well to expand the system. Now, with the 48 volt power supply that it comes with, it does mean that we can power 22 indoor stations if it's the Wi-Fi version. There are two types of screens, one with Wi-Fi, one without. So the Wi-Fi ones, yep, 22 indoor stations. If it doesn't have the Wi-Fi, you can power 64 indoor stations from that same power supply. So it makes it a really neat and tidy and simple installation. So what we'll do, let's get one wired up and just see how we wire it and get it configured and working. So here are the devices that we're going to look at today. As I mentioned, we've got our 48 volt power distribution. We've got our actual main distributor here, which where we put our power cable into there. And we've got our various channels, as I mentioned. We've got the actual door station itself, which is just here. We've got the floor shunt. And then we've got our two screens just there. As you can see, product codes are on the screen there for you now. So let's take a look and see how we're wiring the power block to start with. So here's the main power block itself that we need to put mains into to start with. So I've got some normal three-core wire. It only needs live and neutral. So we've got the live there to the right and neutral on the left. Obviously, of course, make sure this is disconnected from the power whilst wiring this in. So I'm just going to put the first one in now. So our mains power is in there, as we see. Then what we've got here in the top left is we've got four terminals. We've got two lots of V positive and two lots of V negative. So V positive is obviously your live wire and V negative is your neutral wire. That is what's going to wire into our distribution block just at the bottom here. So we need to link from there into this block here. So let's do that now. So as we can see, we've got our 240 volt mains going into the bottom right here, and then out to the top left corner, we've got our live and neutral out, which is pushing 48 volts out. Again, don't forget, at this stage, we do not have any power going to this until we fully set the system up. Next part is, now with these two wires, these now have to go into our distribution box. So let's get those two wires pop in now. So the first one we're going to go with is our neutral wire. To actually use this, use your flathead screwdriver that comes with the actual device themselves, and you simply just push down, hold that little clip down that's just inside there, and then you just slide the wire in to the right inside hole, release that, and then you should feel it tension and grip once it's got a grip of that, which that one has now. That's our neutral in, and now we're going to go with the positive. So again, push that down, place that wire in, feel the little click, give it a bit of pull, and we can see that's in there and secured now. So we've now got our mains going to here, 48 volt out into our 48 volt in. Next thing we do now is wiring our door station. Now our door station can be wired into any of these channels along the top. Let's do this now. So to start with, we're just going to wire in our door station into our distributor box. Again, same principle as when we wired these two in. You just use your flathead screwdriver and push those little clips down just to release it, and that allows you then just to slide the wire in. So if I'm just going to push that one down, find the gap, and then just slide that wire in. That's the red one in, and now for the black one. Okay, two wires are in there now. Obviously, we know we need to connect the other two ends of the wire into our door station, our 7003 door station. If I just turn this over and let's take a look at the back. Now, looking at the back of this door station, we can see our terminal block along the bottom here. What we've got, first of all, the first two is just saying two wire. Now, there's no polarity with these ones, so it doesn't matter which one goes in, but you've got your two wire there. You've then got your NC and NO wiring, your common, your lock, your RS-485, a positive and negative. And then you've also got your ground and alarm in connections there as well. So these are all what go to your different door locking mechanisms or RS-485. If you are connecting any submodules, they just connect into the RS-485 out, and then they daisy chain off depending on which submodule you put in. So to start off with, let's just get the two wires popped into the bottom here. Now, they're now wired in. Now, before we move away from the actual door station itself, we do have to take this cover off. Because this is an analog version, underneath this cover, we have got some dials in there that we need to use to actually address it, depending on what the configuration of this door station is. So let's take a look underneath that. Now, if we take a look inside, we can see we've got these little twist dials just inside. And we use these to actually address and basically give the status of the door station itself. So as you can see there at the top there, we've got times 10 times 1. So it's by times by 10 times by 1, depending on which twist dial you use. We then got basically the top one there, which is asking us for the building number. So this is building number 1. So I would just twist that to the number 1 position. Okay, underneath there, it's asking me for the door station number. Don't forget, intervals are 10 or 1. Now, if this is the main door station, you leave that on 0. If it's a sub door, you turn it to 1. If it's sub door 1 or sub door 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. So again, if it's the main door one, you leave that on 0. Do not change that. If you do, it will think it's a sub door station. On the left-hand side there is if we're connecting in a sort of master station device. And on the right-hand side there, there is also a twist dial, which gives us the door unlock duration, should we wish to use the twist dials for that. But once we've given it the address of the location of what it is, i.e. what building number, what door station it is, we can then put the cover back on there. Now we've got wired in, what we need to do now is wire in our screens. So we're going to wire in the first screen to start with. If I just turn this over and look on the back, again, it gets a little bit confusing if you don't know these devices too well. At the top there, we have actually got one for power, but we disregard that because we are actually using these pins here for two wire in, 48 volt DC. So we've got two wire in and we've got two wire out. So as I mentioned, these screens can daisy chain along. Once you've done that, again, you do have the twist dials here, which you twist them to address them in sequence. So basically building number and room number, and if it is an extension, so you twist the dials accordingly. So let's do this now. Now what we need to do is obviously address this screen. So this is going to be in building room one. One click clockwise, and it's going to be room one. So again, one click clockwise, and that's it, addressed and ready. Let's hook up the second screen. And then don't forget, we need to address our second screen. So this is going to be in the same building, so building one. And we're going to have it in the same room, so it's going to be in room one. So it's going to be an extension screen of the existing main one. So again, it's extension number one. Now that's all wired in, let's take a look at the door station itself, what we've got to do with it, because before this is going to work correctly, we do need to log in and activate the system. So first of all, what I'm going to quickly show you is just behind this silver plate just here, because the device does have a built-in microphone and speaker. If I just put my flathead screwdriver and just push that to the side, that just pops out as we just saw there. And underneath that plate there, we have got a little flap. If I just remove that flap, underneath there, there are two dials which allow us to change the volume of the microphone and the speaker that are built into there. So if you're doing to change those are just located under that flap as we just saw. Just place that back in there, and that just simply pushes back across. Now looking at this, you can see the one call button that comes with this. There is actually a second button underneath here as well. And it's that second button we need to press and hold down to activate the device's built-in Wi-Fi access point. Because to activate the device, we use our mobile phone and we join its local Wi-Fi. Because don't forget, this device is not an IP device. It doesn't sit on the network. But what it can do is generate its own access point just for the purpose of you being able to dial in and change any of the settings that you may need to do. So if I just pop this little flap here underneath where the button actually is, and there we go. There's our normal calling button. That's the access point button, which you press and hold down for a few seconds until you hear a beep. And once you hear that beep, that indicates that the access point has been active. So let me just put that plate back on. Okay. So that plate's now back on. I don't have to have the plate lifted. If I press and hold in that area, which I'm going to do now, I should hear a little beep in a minute to indicate that access point is active. There we go. We've got the beep. This is now transmitting its own Wi-Fi access point. The rest is all done from our mobile phone. So let's take a look and see how we do this. So on our phone, we go to our settings section and go to Wi-Fi. And what we should see there in a moment, and right at the top there, is our Wi-Fi access point. If I click on that top one there, this is now going to try and join the Wi-Fi of the door station itself. It's saying incorrect password. Let me just put the correct password in. Now, the password initially for this one is the actual serial number you're seeing at the top without the AP underscore. So in this case, it's going to be AE, and then that number, which in this case we've got 5397633, and click join. That is now going to join the Wi-Fi access point of that door station. And in a moment, hopefully, it should pop up now asking me to join via the web browser to talk and connect to that device. So just give that a moment or two, and hopefully, it'll pop up in a minute asking us to actually go to the web browser. And here we go. It's now logging in there. So I'm going to go in via Safari in this case because I'm on an iPhone. And here we go now, it's asking me to activate it. I've got to give this device a password of my choice. So again, clicking the password box there. I'm going to use my own password for this case. Pop it in once, and then pop it in twice. And click activate. It's now asking me to set some security questions. In the real world, obviously, you'll select the answers depending on what your choices are. If I just go next, once that's done, it's now asking me if I want to create a reserved email address. Because I've created security questions, I can choose to skip this part now. And language, I'm going to go with English, so let's go next. Time and date settings, they all seem to be correct, which is good. Let's go next. And now that is saying it's done. It's saying there, if I hold the button on the top right of the device for 10 seconds, it will trigger the function and the device linkage indicators will flash and search for the devices. So if I press and hold the button down like it's asking me to do now for 10 seconds, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, there we go. So as we just heard there, you might have heard on my microphone now, it's now searching for the other devices on the system. I can now click complete. So there's a status of my door at the moment. We can see we've got the device component status showing that little radar thing going around saying it's normal. It's telling us the device location, the open duration, and I've got some shortcut keys I can go to as well. So I can go to device management and take a look. Obviously, it's still searching for indoor stations as we currently speak because it's currently doing its search process. So I'll just go back just for the time being. We've got person management. I can add people into the system if I wanted to and obviously put their cards and things in there if I had a card module on there as well. If we go down, we've got password settings, so I can create public passwords again if you're using the keypad option as well. And then we've got door parameters, which we can see the door duration is set to open for 2 seconds. That is grayed out. Why? Well, because we use the twist dial that's on the back of the door station itself to set the door open parameters. But as we can see there, we've got a lot of the settings all on here. Top right corner, got those three lines. If I click top right, I can go under the bonnet of this device and go into more of the detailed settings should I wish to. Again, from here, you can open the door from the app as well.
The door is open.
And see from there, I can even open the door from here as well. Don't forget, my phone is only paired to its own local Wi-Fi. Once I disconnect, I will lose this functionality. This is mainly for your setup procedure. So let's go back and take a look and see how the system is behaving at the moment. So now that system is activated, as we saw through the mobile app, what I could do now is simply press the call button on here. And what we'll do, we'll get the call through to the main screen. And from the main screen there, we have the facility to answer the call, as well as open the door and do our two-way audio from that screen as well. Obviously, I just ended the call just there. So there we go, everyone. Fairly straightforward in how to actually configure one of these 7003 modular door stations, the analog ones. It is worth pointing out, however, you cannot mix this door station, the analog ones, with the older existing two-wire digital ones, nor can you mix it with the IP version either. It is a fully standalone independent device separate from the others. That also means the peripherals cannot be mixed either. So the screens have to be for this particular door station, as does the distributor box, as does the power supply. They are all specific for this product range. If you do want more information on these devices, go to the description below. All the links are in there as always, as well as any contact details to get in touch with ourselves if you have any queries. And as always, if you did like that, please do leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe. And again, hit that bell icon. That way we'll be alerted when we upload any new videos.